Hello, my name is Jay Burrows, and welcome to the series on overcoming. Today we're going to talk about discipline. First thing I'd like to do is read a scripture from the King James Version, Proverbs 25, verse 28. He that hath no rule over his own spirit is like a city that is broken down without walls. Now that scripture touching on being broken down without walls is kind of like where we are in life. A lot of people walk around without any protection, no covering. Those that are not believers, those of us that are believers, Christ is our protection. That is our walls. That is our foundation. We are citizens of the kingdom of heaven. But it takes discipline to live the lifestyle that we live. A lot of sacrifice, a lot of denial, and things of that nature. One thing I wanted to talk about as far as discipline is I worked out a lot. Weightlifting, training for athletic tournaments and things like that as a basketball player, also with martial arts as well. And when you encounter or take on any kind of discipline, there's a lot that goes with it. It takes a lot of time, takes a lot of patience, a lot of sacrifice, a lot of doing stuff for a greater goal. So in all essence, it's not very pleasurable. So you get a thing where you're pushing for a goal, but at the same time, your body and your flesh is dying inside. I know many times from weightlifting, because I wanted to look a certain kind of way or be able to athletically do something like jump higher, move, run faster, you know, or be sharper, or lift a certain amount of weight, then I would have to punish my body. Literally punish my body to get to where I wanted to be. And that's what discipline entails. You're going to have to make that sacrifice of getting up, let's say 6 o'clock in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning, when you know your body is tired from the night before, or you know that bed just feels like it's pulling you back in, and you have to fight that and move forward to get to the goal that you want. So I always like to say there's a light at the end of the tunnel that you're trying to get to, and everybody's moving in that direction. When it came to weightlifting for me, my hardest day was leg day. Leg day was intense, but leg day was also one of the most painful days that I had to endure. If I could skip leg day, I probably would have, but I knew I couldn't, because I felt that when you train, I would usually start off the week with training legs. Because I pictured my body as a tree and I wanted to build from the ground up. So I built from my roots up or upward to get the results that I wanted. So I would lift heavy on my legs some days, some leg days I would do light, but it was like a lot of repetition. But either way, no matter what, when I ended in pain. I walked in the gym quick and ready to go. When I walked out, very slow motion, very tight, very tender. Every step was like a baby step. And what normally the walk would take me about 5 minutes, 3 to 5 minutes to get to the gym, because it's right at the block for me. But to go home would take me now anywhere from 10 minutes to 12 minutes because my body was so tired and so tender and so sore. So I had to make those sacrifices. But when I looked at it, after maybe about 2 to 3 weeks, the results started to show. I was able to jump higher, run faster. You seen the muscular development within my legs, and I pushed forward on that because that was the inspiration that I needed to move forward. We as believers have that same thing that we're doing. We're building up ourselves to get into God's kingdom, to be citizens of heaven, to carry out his will. That is the light for us at the end of the tunnel, to tell people about this amazing, amazing God that we serve. But there are sacrifices in his will along the way. Denying your flesh. And denying the flesh is not easy. It's one of the most hardest things that you will ever do. I had a pastor tell me at one time that the greatest enemies that we face are our flesh. Then it's the world, then it's the enemy. Because the flesh is so in tune with this world, it wants what it wants. And before we came to Christ, we opened ourselves up to a lot of things. Me, personally, I opened myself up to lust, pornography, a lot of sexual encounters and things of that nature, which I had to deny my flesh of. But once it's had a taste for it, it's going to fight you daily. And being that I'm no longer a porn addict, I still do have these urges. But I explain it like this. It's like being inside of a movie theater, where when I first started on this journey, pornography was so big to me. It was the 40-foot screen that sits right in front of you in a movie theater, and I was sitting front row. Whereas now in my life, it's same movie theater, but it's like a 10-inch Zenith TV on the floor, and I'm sitting way in the back row. Now, is it there? Yes. It'll always be there because I'm in this flesh, because my flesh has been open to that door. That door has been open, and my flesh knows what it is, but I have more of a handle on it than I did before. I'm not compelled to go and watch pornography or be into lust. It's not a big thing for me any longer. I know many people that I have been friends with, drinking was an obstacle for them, drug use was an obstacle for them, smoking was an obstacle for them. Those things weren't my obstacles. And God bless you for those who've overcome any of those things. It's addiction is a thing when your flesh is open to something and it moves on it because it's a compulsion. We as believers in Christ know that we don't adhere to the flesh, we adhere to the Spirit. So the Spirit will guide you and it'll tell you simply, don't do that. Don't look at this. Turn that off. And when you are in tune and obedient, which is one big piece, you have to be obedient. You can hear, but if you don't obey, that's a different story. But you have to obey. But when you hear the Spirit speaking to you and it's telling you, listen, turn that off. Turn those things off. Don't look at that or don't listen to that. You tune into something else. It's not easy, but it's a day-by-day process. This is how the Spirit draws you closer, because if you can adhere to the smaller things, you'll definitely adhere to when it's bigger, when there's really something going on, and the Spirit needs to let you know. But it all starts with discipline. Those first little small steps, we all take baby steps to get where we want to be. I've never seen anyone walk into a gym, brand new, never lifted a weight in their life or trained a day in their life, and was incredibly strong or fast or anything of that nature. It always came as a process. We've all been blessed with certain kinds of gifts that can aid us in this process to move on. But we have to utilize it in God's way. God has a way of thinking. God has a way of doing things. They're not our ways. And as believers, we have taken on, we put aside ourselves to take on the mind of Christ, to be in tune with what God is doing. Our discipline is a daily thing to keep that being in tune. When you get up in the morning, that opening prayer, thanking God for giving you the day, that's a prayer answered also, because that prayer that you may have prayed the night before is tomorrow. Make it a blessed day for tomorrow. And that prayer has been answered because you opened your eyes, you're clothed, you're in your right mind, you're standing on your own two feet. I always tell my friends I'm happy for the day that I'm able to change tomorrow because of today. Without today, I can't affect my tomorrow. But being that I'm blessed with this moment right here in time, I can affect change within my tomorrow. But that's through the guidance of the Holy Spirit. And that's the one thing I'm very thankful for. When I set out to write the book, Pulling the Truth, the Whole Truth and Nothing But the Truth, I also was opening myself up to be honest to people about what I was going through and the situations I had been through. But it took discipline for me to get up and write every single day. It took discipline for me to expose the different things that I had been going through because I felt ashamed about it. But the Holy Spirit guided me and kept reminding me that this is not just about you. This is about the people who may have or may have, are, or going through these kinds of situations. They need help just as much as anybody else. And it comes from a place where I'm not holier than anyone else. I've fallen just like everyone else, and I'm continuing to fight the battle. And that's one of the biggest things that a lot of people, when I speak to people, if I do any kind of events where I'm speaking, people understand this about me. They see the passion in me. They see what I've gone through. And I give the examples. I give it to you cut and dry. I don't sugarcoat anything. I tell the truth. And that's what this whole book was always about. And that line of discipline, it wasn't easy. It was very hard for me. It was a sacrifice that I feel I had to make. I needed to make. Just to have that weight of guilt and that shame lifted off of me. You know, they say, tell the truth and shame the devil. Because the devil doesn't want you to tell the truth. The enemy refuses to have you tell the truth. And he will do anything and everything to stop you. It is your discipline that gets you through. Those small steps you take turn into a bigger tomorrow. So I thank you guys for listening. And I really appreciate the time that you're taking out. Just take the disciplined steps to move forward in your life. Each small step becomes a greater one as you look back. You look back on where you once were and where God picked you up at and what He's brought you through. And you will amaze yourself at any and every time. Anytime you feel down, just take a look back at what He's brought you through. And that relationship that you're building with the Most High, the relationship you have with Jesus and the guidance of the Holy Spirit is the one thing that will always bring you through. Once again, my name is Jay Burrows. I am the author of Porn, The Truth, The Whole Truth, and Nothing But The Truth. I appreciate your time, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Thank you. Be blessed. Be well.